You know, as we look around today, we see the godly and the ungodly. I'm sure you would agree with me when I say the world is full of corruption, lies, lust, deceit. It doesn't have to be this way. There's going to be a judgment day. And we're all going to be judged for the life that we led. But even if we do some good, but we're not living righteously, well, then there's going to be a punishment. How could you sacrifice your life for silver and gold to gain the whole world and lose your soul? Oh no, is it worth it when you're in the back of a hearse? About to face the dirt, now you're laying up the church. Silent as a mouse, you couldn't take your money or your cars or your house. You left it all out for your kids and your spouse to work it all out. The tears that they cried and the words that they spoke dried up in a day, showing no remorse. Now they're going through your stuff, seeing what you left them. Didn't know your father was cheating and abetting. He left you with the bills and a life full of stressing. That's when the miss walked in on the blessing. The preacher said your father was a good man and he's resting.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
The confession and the kids, they had their regrets. Never seen their father, only used it for a check. And the mother had her own relationship, drinking out the bottles, still left the hollow. No love, no peace, she only fell asleep when she was drunk and had too much to drink. All she wanted was love and affection. Now she's in the house all alone with no attention. Now he's faced with the undertaker to take him to his maker, our God the creator, to find out where his fate lies. Will he go to hell or live in paradise? He starts to review his life so he can see the way that he had lived and the way he was conceived. As he focused with his eyes wide open, he hears all the cursing and the sinning he was doing. All the fornication with the pornography, the lies and deceit, and the jealousy, with the adultery that was listed, and seeing all the grace from God that was given, and the godly man that came to him speaking. Jesus is the truth and the way, he did receive them. Now he's on his knees begging and he's pleading. Hell just increases his number with another heathen.
No.
The confession. No rest, no lights, no peace. He's in the lake of fire with garnishing the teeth. Weeping and the pain will never cease. This is his demise for the way he lived his life. He's calling out for his friends and family.
Turn away!
To turn away from sin before this happens to them. But they can't hear him and falls on deaf ears. Satan starts to laugh and says, I see the
year. They can't hear you.